So we slept over at Great Haywood, managing to find a pump out and fill up the diesel at a very competitive 94 pence a litre, and we're moving on to see what the day brings. Canal and river transport vessel there with the day cabin at the back and the cargo at the front. And there's polytunnels full of strawberries all growing off the ground in what you could describe as giant hanging baskets. It's Wimbledon at the moment, perhaps they're supplying strawberries to Wimbledon at £100 a punnet. Toby, that's a nice bone, it's for sale. Interesting. Two of us met at the bridge. There's only room for one boat at a time. That's my day scare done before I've even started. Some narrow boats off out of the water over there upon blocks. Makes you realise how much is below the waterline when you look at them when they're out of the water. Again, it just never fails to amaze me how many boats are moored up in marinas all over the waterways. Literally thousands. So in relation to the boats that are on the water, most of them are in the marina. Otherwise the canals would be so rammed you'd never get anywhere. An interesting arrangement. It's like a little basin in there where all that rusty bridge is, and there's two extremely rusty narrow boats moored up in there. Shouldn't think have been used in years. You know, in these days of elf and safety and the erosion of basic common sense and taking responsibility for your own self, these locks, I'm surprised, haven't been raided by the elf and safety brigade, because some of them have got some very clear hazards. There's no safety rails, for instance, around where you push the lock gates open, and it is a drop. Just here where the steps are, you could easily, if you weren't paying attention, step backwards and fall off. Don't misunderstand me, I'm not saying I want the health and safety to get involved, I'm just making an observation. This is where I was talking about where if you step back when opening the lock gates, you could drop off. Personally, I love them. I think they're really full of character and history. So you have to use the ground paddle before the gate paddles, and there's the ground paddle there, and the reason you open the ground paddle first is so that you don't swamp the front of the boat when the water comes in where the gates are. And there's the old lock keeper's cottage. Thanks, then. So that was Hoo Mill Lock. That's a very dramatic sky. It looks like it's going to absolutely throw it down with buckets of water. Scout on patrol, the bulldogs had a den just like that. In a hurry. Hello. Hello. Black Prince Holidays. They're definitely Captain Adventure on an adventure. Watch the boats go by. Interesting. A river canal rescue vessel, the equivalent of the RAC and AA on the waterways. Sharp right hand bends. This boat just coming up on the left hand side. Looks like he started Kew Gardens. And he's using his fender as the base for it. So you could call it Fender Gardens. It's an interesting display. Hello. 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 thanks for waiting.
Well, we're waiting for another boat, but it went in the boatyard.
Oh,
we just saw you.
It was excellent timing. Shardlow 46, Preston Brook 48, so we're almost on the halfway mark. That's the peak. That position we started out was just an ordinary
house.
They've done some serious. It's nicely kept. Yeah. Stone town in Staffordshire, history of the canal. I'll put a link in the description. Right next to where the water point is an M&S. Food hall. That's useful, isn't it?